God bless you. I'm preaching today from my backyard in front of a lavender bush on a beautiful sunny Sunday afternoon. God bless you. I want to start by talking about how little children, they don't worry about things. You know, the little children, they don't worry about where their next meal is coming from. They don't worry about bills. They don't worry about the economy. They just have this childlike trust that everything's going to be okay, that their parents are going to provide for them, and so they don't worry about things. And as believers, it's the same for us. We have this trust knowing that our Heavenly Father looks after us and takes care of us in every situation. We don't have to worry about a thing. And I want to start by reading from Matthew 6, and it's a scripture we all know well. And it says, "But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown in the furnace, will he much more clothe you, you of little faith? Do not worry then, saying, 'What shall we eat?' Or 'What will we drink?' Or 'What will we wear for clothing?' For the Gentiles eagerly seek all these things. But your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you." For us in the Lord, we know that in every situation, he's there for us, looking out for us. We don't have to worry about a thing. Not at all. We can have joy in every situation. Yes, we cry tears of repentance when we come to the Lord. You know, for myself, you know, I know that when I came to the Lord, I thought I was a good person. And I've shared this before, how, you know, I was okay. I don't think I stole from people. I didn't consider myself bad in any way. Then when I came into his presence, when that power of God hit my heart, I knew I was a sinner. I knew that I needed him. And so, you know, yes, we cry those tears of repentance. But then after the tears of repentance, there's joy. Now, it's God who gives us that conviction. It's him. He's the one that does it. Nobody had to nag me. Nobody had to pester me. That's how I got saved. It was the power of God that convicted me of sin. But I'm actually going to talk about the joy of the Lord because, you know, yes, there is that time of tears. And yes, there is that time of repentance. But there is also that time of joy. Beautiful joy that we have in the Lord. And it reminds me so much of the story of Nehemiah. You know, in the book of Nehemiah, it talks about the rebuilding of the wall. The book of Ezra was about the rebuilding of the temple. The book of Nehemiah is about rebuilding the wall. And I look upon it as a parallel to how we get stronger and stronger in the Lord. Because, you know, for Nehemiah, as the wall was being rebuilt in those times, that meant security. They didn't have to worry about the plans of the enemy, the schemes of the enemy. They had those big, strong walls. You know, they could sit, you know, in their houses with the walls around them, knowing that it didn't matter what the enemy was doing. They had that peace. And so in Nehemiah, it talks about how, you know, the wall was supernaturally built in 52 days. Right? Whereas, you know, they tried before they'd spent years and years trying to rebuild it and nothing had happened. But under the direction of the Lord, it was finished in 52 days. And how, you know, there was a time of weeping. There was a time of sadness. You know, they found the book of the law. And it was, you know, they read from the book of the law. And great conviction came upon the people. You know, in Nehemiah 6, you know, Ezra was the one that was reading it out. Sorry, Nehemiah 8, verse 6. Ezra was reading it out, the prophet Ezra. And it says, "Then Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people answered, 'Amen, amen.' While lifting their hands, they bowed low and worshipped the Lord with their faces to the ground. So there was this conviction as Ezra was reading the book of the law to all the people. But then after that, I'll just go to verse 9. Then Nehemiah, who was the governor, and Ezra the priest and the scribe and the Levites, who taught all the people, said to all the people, "This day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep." For all the people were weeping when they heard the words of the law. Then he said to them, "Go eat of the fat, drink of the sweet, and send portions to him who has nothing prepared. For this day is holy. Do not be grieved, for the joy of the Lord is your strength." So initially there was that weeping, that time of repentance. But after that, there was the joy. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. We know that it is the devil who comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And he wants to rob us of our joy. You know, he wants to steal it from us. And the way that we can lose our joy is what happens when we get our eyes off the Lord and onto the situation and the circumstances that are going on around us. I think, for instance, of Jesus on the fishing boat. You know, the disciples there, they saw this big storm come up. And they were all getting worried and anxious. They were looking at the circumstances and how big it all seemed. And there was Jesus. He was asleep on this boat, not worried about a thing. And the disciples getting anxious. "Oh, Jesus, help us. We're going to die. We're going to die." They woke him up. And Jesus, when he got up, you know, he told them off. He said to them, "Why are you fearful, O ye of little faith?" Because they were worried about the situation going on around them. They thought, they'd let that situation, what was on the outside, overcome them. They didn't have the peace of the Lord anymore. They didn't have his peace. They'd lost their joy. They'd lost their trust. They'd got caught up in the situation. We see it with Peter, for example. You know, there was a time when Peter walked on water, summoned by the Lord, Jesus. And there he was, you know, he got out of the boat and he walking on water towards the Lord. But then he suddenly realized what he was doing. He started to look at the situation going on around him, getting anxious, getting worried. And then he started to sink. He'd gotten his eyes off the Lord and onto the situation. Now, for us, you know, we need to keep our eyes always on the Lord, always rejoicing, always focused on him, praising him. In Matthew 24, you can read in Matthew 24, the Lord actually says, and it's his words, the words of Christ Jesus in Matthew 24, how things are going to get worse, not better. Right? I'm going to read you a bit from Matthew 24. And Jesus answered them, this is from verse 4, "See to it that no one misleads you, for many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Christ,' and will mislead many. You will be hearing of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not frightened, for these things must take place, but that is not the end. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and in various places there will be famines and earthquakes. But all these things are merely the beginning of the birth pangs." So there he's actually saying, things are going to get worse than what they are. You know, people at the moment are very fearful out there. They're fearful about the situation. They're not fearful about the living God who's able to throw them, you know, cast them into hell. That's whom they should be fearful of. You know, people are getting caught up in the situation. But for us, we know there's nothing to fear. We have that wonderful childlike trust in Almighty God. I want to read you a bit from 1 John 4. And it talks about how perfect love casts out all fear. 1 John 4 verse 17, it says, "By this love is perfected with us, so that we may have confidence in the day of judgment." Right? So we can have confidence, we can have boldness in the day of judgment when everybody else is fearful. Because as he is, so also are we in this world. There is no fear in love. Right? There's no fear in love, but perfect love casts out all fear, because fear involves punishment, and the one who fears is not perfected in love. So we're not to fear about situations and about circumstances. Fear can really mess people up. It can be debilitating. People can be anxious about everything, washing their hands 50 times a day, all worried, all nervous about situations, afraid to step out of even the house. For us in the Lord, we have that childlike trust in our Heavenly Father. We don't worry about things, because he absolutely loves us. I want to talk about, a beautiful verse at the end of Matthew 23. And this verse really blesses me. And it's Jesus, and he's talking about, let me just read it for you. He says in Matthew 23, verse 37, "Jerusalem, Jerusalem, who kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to her, how often I wanted to gather your children together the way a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, and you were unwilling." So there we know that the Lord was rejected, he was hated, he was persecuted. But there he has this beautiful image where he still has that heart where he wants to, gather his children, gather his people like a hen gathering his chicks, gathering her chicks, under the wings, And you think of, for us, he's like our great shepherd, where we don't worry about things. He's the Lord is our shepherd. We do not worry. He leads us to green pastures. We don't have to worry about things. Even if we're going through the valley of the shadow of death, he's still there with us. His rod and his staff, they comfort us. Psalm 23. But know this, that we are God's people. And he loves us and he cares for us. And we've been bought for a price. That price was great. But he went to that cross and died for us, which demonstrates his great love towards us. He's not going to let anything bad happen to his people. We just got to have that childlike trust where we don't fear him, we don't worry about things, because he's there with us in every situation. So God bless you all on this Sunday afternoon. I hope you're having a lovely day. I find it quite difficult, interesting, preaching in a backyard. I've had drones fly over, I've had pigeons, people playing on trampolines. But I just want to wish you I just want to bless you this day. And I pray, though, that you have a beautiful day. Amen.